Some new reaction now to the Transportation Security Administration's decision to extend its face mask requirement until September now. You're going to have to keep wearing your face coverings at all airports, on buses, and also rail systems. And here to talk about the future of travel is Sara Nelson, International President of the Association of Flight Attendants. Hey, Sara, good to have you back on the broadcast. I'm curious this question. How important is it that the mask mandate has been extended? What does that mean to airline employees? Do you think there's a sense of relief that they're going to be required now, at least a few months past the prior May deadline?
Well, let's be really clear. This is not an extension of the mask mandate by itself, but the enforcement of that mandate. So it's really important. Scientists and healthcare professionals are telling us that we need to continue to wear those masks in enclosed spaces, even when people are vaccinated, so that we are not carrying variants of the virus or carrying the virus itself until we have everyone vaccinated. So we need to continue to wear these masks in enclosed spaces, and there's no more close space than the space that we work in the aircraft cabin. And so what this says is that the federal government is really backing us up in doing our jobs. They're saying that when flight attendants say you need to wear the mask and comply with that, that there's a zero tolerance policy from the FAA if you're interfering with those flight attendants' instructions and duties, and that TSA is going to enforce this in the airports as well, and there will be fines and potentially jail time if you're not following through, just like if you smoked on a plane and put everyone in jeopardy.
Gotta say, with the frequency with which I fly, I'm so relieved. I'm just glad that you're going to have to be really tough about it, and I'm really grateful for it, frankly. But there is this new report by Axios, and it says 72% of Americans are planning summer trips, with campsites, Airbnbs, flights, rental cars rapidly booking up right now. It was like half of that the summer of 2020. So do you have a sense of what airports are going to look like?
Yeah, airports are going to be a lot more crowded, and so it's really important that everyone follow the rules, because what we don't want to do is extend this pandemic. I have to tell you, it's a little strange to be over a year into this pandemic and realize and think back to what it was like, for example, when we were dealing with the Ebola outbreak, and how vigilant we were in stopping the spread of that virus at transportation's door. So there's a little bit of pandemic fatigue going on here, but let's all continue to listen to the healthcare professionals, the scientists, get everyone vaccinated, continue to wear those masks in enclosed spaces, and really respect that so that we can all get back to normal. Everybody's ready to travel and get out, and so those airports will be probably quite full, and you're going to see a lot of full flights. You should prepare for that. But we can do it safely if we all follow the rules.
So TSA leaders say, look, we're working to recruit. We need about 6,000 new officers by summer, but they say many positions are unfilled so far. So does that concern you? What kind of a situation could this create at the airports and also on flights potentially?
Well, it's always difficult when we have staffing shortages at TSA, and that's a problem when we see government shutdowns and there's not continued funding, and when there's cutbacks in government funding. But it's also a problem when those TSA agents don't have the ability to get on the general pay scale with the rest of the federal government and attract people to those jobs because they're good jobs with good pay and good benefits. We're talking about that this week in front of Congress about this very issue. And it's one of the ways that we can attract people to this work and make sure that we're staffed up for the summer and ready to meet the demand.
Let me ask you real quick, how long do you think it's going to take for the airline industry to fully recover? I mean, because it can't open overnight.
Well, one thing that's really important to recognize is that this is going to take an international network to be able to recover. And so one of the things that we're doing is we're also focusing on getting the vaccine distributed all around the world so that we can continue to travel safely to all these countries and attract people to the United States. As long as there's travel restrictions and international travel, we're not going to fully recover. And as things stand right now today, experts are saying that they're not seeing a full recovery of the airline industry until 2024. So the more that we can do to spread those vaccines around and get out of this pandemic, the faster that we will all recover and have those safe jobs and have a network that will support all the other industries that count on air travel.
Just another good reason to get vaccinated, everybody. Take a listen to Sara Nelson. Thank you so much, Sara.